he did a responsible thing by storing it someplace else, probably so that you wouldn't get your hands on it. I don't know that for sure. If the bike was being used and it didn't have insurance on it, I might be sympathetic with at least part of your argument that you assumed that since the bike was being driven by its owner, it was insured as was required. That's what you said in your answer, sir. I'm just quoting you. But you went to pick up the bike where it was not being used, and you did that deliberately. He didn't drive it over there and say, well, I'm going to come back for it in an hour. I don't care if he left it there for a day, a week, a month, or 6 months. He brought it there for the purpose of not using it, which is why it wasn't insured. It didn't have to be insured if it was sitting in a garage.
Well, by law, it's supposed to be insured if it's financed.
That has nothing to do with you. Riding. You see, if you're riding a motor vehicle and you're not insured, if you hurt somebody else, that's why the government gets involved. See, the government gets involved because they don't want idiots like you to hurt somebody without insurance. As between this young man and the finance company, if he had had an accident while he was riding in that bike, he was going to be responsible for that, and they were going to take it out of his check and his father's, because he co-signed for it. But as between the moron who took the bike without permission, actually stole it, because if your grandmother wasn't home, she couldn't even give you permission to take it. And I'm absolutely positive that he asked your grandmother for permission to store his bike there. Absolutely positive. And once he gives his grandmother that authority, if you took the bike out of the garage without Eunice's permission and without his, then you stole it.
No, I didn't steal it.
Yes, you did, sir.
It's not
you stole it. You stole it.
Well,
you stole it because you didn't have his permission that day, and you didn't have Eunice's permission, who was actually the bailor of that, because he left the bike there under her authority. So there's a reason why your father doesn't like you, and there's a reason why your brother doesn't like you, because I don't like you. And I'm a pretty good judge of character.
Judge Judy continues in a moment.
He's always going to be in trouble.
Just wish he'd all not
He's always going to be in trouble.
How do you know that?
I know, because that's why I'm here for 14 years.
Yeah.
Always. Was a dent on the car? Was this on the car when you took it? Yes or no?
We all have the power to make a difference.
My thing is, never give up.
Incredible stories of survival from children who have the power to make a difference. Tonight at 10:30 on Fox 29.
I'm Arlen Specter, and I approve this message.
Joe Sestak pays most of his campaign staff less than minimum wage, but pays thousands to his relatives. Joe Sestak, just another politician.
Dan Adorado calls himself the Democrat, but he opposes a woman's right to choose and sensible guidance to protect our families. And unemployment has risen a whopping 30% in just the last year.
Yeah, he's still hasn't cashed most of the checks he's done right now.
On everything from swimming to parking.
You got,
I'm glad he got his driver's license. Yeah, you ready?
Honorado says
years.
The change we need is Honorado the change we need.
He got a foundation to pay for $800, right?
For what?
He got a foundation to pay for each year today.
Yeah, I know.
No, you got it today.
Yeah, I know. Was the driveway sealed?
Yeah, we just sealed today.
Let's say the other room is no better position.
The best channel lineup and more HD, America's top rated internet. Even Facebook and Twitter on your TV.
I thought it was just going to be all
enjoy
more
a bigger, better entertainment experience.
Exactly.
And the peace of mind.
Much nicer.
Knowing you'll pay the same low price year after year.
Great big.
Call now and you'll also get a free PVR for 6 months.
Comfort in
for just $99.99 a month with a 2-year agreement.
Right, a price guaranteed
for 2 years.
Don't
wait.
Call
1-888-818-FIVES. That's 1-888-818-FIVES.
This is Beyond.
This is Vikes.
I'm Arlen Specter, and I approve this message.
Joe Sestak has
here.
The worst attendance record of any campaign.
We move into the Comfort Inn after the race.
Sestak campaign.
It's no bigger than this room.
No, it has, it's a Comfort Inn and Suites. The Inn is no bigger than this, and the Suites is a beast.
Are we staying in the Suites?
Yeah, after the next Monday, yeah.
I thought the gift was staying in the Suites.
Marcus Lindbergh
like
took
this
motorcycle without
permission.
That's what I'm saying, that's $59 a night.
Now, this case should never have gotten here.
Mm-hmm.
You should have said, I drove by, I totaled it, you got a $10,000 budget payoff, or maybe $8,000 left, I don't know how much you have left, how much?
Yes, $5,900, I actually made the first 2.5 years of my, that's the money that you used to salvage. To live on?
I think when we get, after that, after we'll probably go up to six, and when we come back, when we stay in the Comfort Inn, will it be a big room?
Did you sell any of the parts?
We can't get in the nice room, this Sunday?
Yeah, $1,200 for the engine.
We'll be saying for main sale.
So your out-of-pocket expense is $4,700.
No, you know, main sale suite?
You have to pay to the.
That's the one we never went to the. No.
Always has been.
We're saying at the main sale.
Yeah.
I'd like to see it.
We're saying at the main sale suite for the 4 days, the race.
Give me an extra for them.
Is this son still living here? When did he move out?
Scoot up a little, scoot up a little.
I can't scoot up anymore, man.
Are you telling me you kicked him out?
He hasn't lived with me for several years, I don't know where this came from, where he lived with me.
Then how did he get to take this bike?
Alex had his own apartment at the time the bike was stolen. That's why the bike was stored at the grandmother's house, not at my house, I was at the grandmother's house, then stole the bike, crashed the bike, then fled the scene, and as I, yeah, because I needed to get help.
Shut up. Listen.
Yes, ma'am.
Do you work?
Yes, ma'am.
You live alone?
I live with my cousin.
You've been living with your cousin in an apartment for a while?
About a year, yes.
You have a reasonable life?
It's a good life for now.